Hello, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Tim, and it is Tuesday evening. It is slightly later than I wanted to, and I have had a very, very, very bad day. But you know what? We're here now, and it's time to play some games. So, fuck all that bad juju and noise. We're here to have a good time. And I have a large group of chat venturers below me. So let's play some games. So let's start off by checking in on our Dungeoneers. We haven't checked in on them in quite some time. We have here, in our stable of users, Dan the Chump, who will perennially be the Chump. Harwood the Mime, whom I don't think we have Harwood in right now, so we may have to pick a new Mime. We'll hold off on that. Dan is also the Barbarian at the moment, which is an honor that we'll let him hold on to until he happens to lose it. Nightmari was our Bruiser, but I don't see Nightmari in here. I thought... No, that was Tiamos. Tiamos that I saw in here earlier. So I might have to make him something like that. But anyway, then we have Zombie, who is not here. Reigns, who is not here. Kisty, who is, and she is the cat burglar. Weasel, who is still the apprentice. And that is it. That is it. So, I believe that first up on the shapeshifter realm, we will put Awer down on the shapeshifter realm. Excellent. Tiamos, if you want to, this is actually a game that you can play right along with us. So pick your chat venturer, my friend. You can choose from the ranger, or the bruiser, or the mime. Those are your three classes that you can choose from. Oh, ha 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 ha. You know what, Huntsman? You're absolutely right. Huntsman, you are our ranger. So then, Tiamos, your choices are down to the mime, or the Bruiser. Now, I will say this, the Bruiser is a little bit more difficult of a class to maintain because there's a lot of attacks that use your health as more damage. And then the Mime is a surprisingly utilitarian class, so if you want to, you're welcome to play along. I won't use you at first, so that way you can kind of get a gauge as to how this game works, but the choices are yours and yours alone. So I wish you luck. In the meantime, we'll kind of let him make his choice and see how this game goes for him. We have two new dungeons that we unlocked at the end of the last game, so that's kind of nice. The Ogre Menace, where we must defeat the ogre while he's still sleepy. This is only a one quest dungeon, surprisingly enough. Okay. Cool, Tiamos, and I will put you in. And then we have the adventure here all mixed up. And it's a two quest dungeon starting with wildlife, where we must defend ourselves against what I'm assuming is wildlife. And we still have to escape with this goddamn gem. I swear on all that is holy, we will escape with this treasure. The treasure will be mine. But first, I think that we're gonna go back into Dungeoneers and Awer said, or excuse me,
hey,
TMO said that he wants, oh, Technid. Thank you so much, my friend. I really appreciate that, man. Every dollar that you guys put into the show goes right back into it to make it an even better show for you guys. So I really, really appreciate that. And yes, the teeny tiny has decided to join us. Hello, teeny tiny.
Oh, he's so cute.
She has been very, very mouthy lately. And very needy. And it's weird because I've never really seen a cat that, You know what, Jezben? You're absolutely right. Kisty, will you take care of that, please? The title and the game, if you don't mind. Oh, and you know what? Since Jezben is here, I'm going to go ahead and put him in as our bruiser. Love it. Love it. Love it. So it looks like we actually have a full contingent of present chadventurers. How the fuck about that? I feel pretty good. All right, so let's go back exploring. I want to see this one quest dungeon. It makes me think that, you know what? Oh, Noble, it's okay. It's okay, you're here. We haven't even really started yet, so you're fine. I think we'll go ahead and start off with Huntsman, who's been waiting to play his ranger for quite some time. And we're going to see exactly what this assassination, this assassination is all about. Defeat the ogre while he's still sleepy. I wonder if we're going to make an entrance from the rear. Oh, Boogie. Hey, Kiki. You behind me. You behind me, Kiki. Okay, so let's take a look here. The ogre is sleeping, and he will take 10 turns to wake up. But in the meantime, there's a mega chest and a large chest here. That could be pretty good. There's a level 2 harpy and a level 3 gargoyle. Ew, those are things we haven't really taken on yet. So, I don't know. We'll see. Okay. First, let's lay out a corridor that is going to make us be able to spread out nice and evenly. Let's go in this direction next. And then I think I want to put down Frenzied Goblin. Yeah, I think we're going to have to go with the Bloodstarved Bat. Predictable is a whole hell of a lot better than Fury, okay? Him having to play with the top card of his deck exposed is a lot better than making it so that the enemy hits us hard after it gets to half health. So, we have here Huntsman's first battle against this Bloodstarved Bat. Now, the Bloodstarved Bat, for those who may not have joined us before, I'm going to kind of explain this first battle so that way you see the way that this works. We have two sets of cards here, two decks of cards that we pull from for our attacks and the enemy pulls from for their attacks. Obviously, blue is us and red is going to be dead very soon. And so, as he pulls from his cards, there are things such as physical and magical attacks, physical and magical defense. There are unblockable and swift tokens, as well as things to draw cards and heal yourself. And some other cards that I will get to as they come along. So, this Bloodstarved Bat is going to start off with an attack called Spook, which does 1 magical damage and blocks 1 physical damage. So what we need to do is figure out some way to block that magical damage and not attack with physical because it'll get blocked. So, we're going to use Camouflage, which is one of the Ranger special abilities here. It'll block this magic damage that's coming our way and store up an attack token for the next round, which we're going to use very quickly, because he's going to start out with here with a huge lunge, which is 2 unblockable physical damage. And so we have the Steelhead Arrow, which, thanks to the 1 physical damage that we have stored up, is now going to be 3 damage, and also thanks to the range trait that the Ranger naturally starts with, all of his physical damage becomes quick. Now, during the normal progression of battle, the enemy always attacks first. Unless you have a quick attack. Which now that... Oh my god. Oh, that's gonna hurt. That's gonna hurt super bad. He's gonna take 1 damage from it. But we're gonna be down to 2. And then this is where that ranged come into play. Because he could hit us here and heal that 1 heart. And that would be very, very bad for us, because that would mean we would have to deal a lot of damage next turn. But because we have this ranged fall physical attacks are quick, we will use this Pierce instead of Flame Arrow, which has 2 damage. But instead, this Pierce will happen first, which means the Bloodstarved Bat dies before it has a chance to hit us back. And that means Huntsman wins the round. So, Huntsman, what is your choice, my friend? We have the Male Coif here, which will give you +2 health, but it'll give you 2 stupidity cards added into your deck. The Wooden Stool, which has 1 stupidity card, blocking 3 damage for repel, and Bash, which is a 1-1. And then we have the Arcane Wand, which is rekindle, 1 magical damage, and heal 1 heart, and then Mind Strike, 1 magic damage, and draw a card. So, which would you choose, sir? Which would you choose? And this is the part where I leave the decisions up to the chat venturers. You guys give me the cards to fight with in the deck. Take note, Tiamos. As we go through, you will choose your chat venturing equipment, and that will determine the cards that go into your deck. Hey, Reigns, welcome. We were actually just talking about you. Well, when we started the show, you were still in the registry of Chat Ventures, so I'm glad that you came back, and I will put you back in post-haste, as soon as we, you know, clear out some space. Coin Pick Stool. You got it, sir. The Repel and Bash is yours. Honestly, I would say that that's a wise choice. The 2 health is great and all, but being able to block damage is phenomenal. Alright, so we're going to progress on towards this Harpy here, but first, let's lay down some gold, and then lay down some more gold. Oh, shit. The ogre wakes in 9 turns. I forgot about that. Okay. Let's progress forward. Doop. And to the harpy, which has feral 3 and demonic 2. I'm going to put that gold back there because we're going to have to come back anyway. And it's going to be 2 spaces that we can travel no matter what. And thanks to the Phylogis Tonic, we still have +1 heart. He's going to start out with a sweeping blast. And that's not good. So I don't know how much magic blocking we have, but we shall see. I want to start off with Flame Arrow, but I'm going to hold off on that because he's going to block one of our damages. But if we start here, then it does it first instead, and we go ahead and deal one of our actual damages and can save this up for when we need it. I could repel this, but I'm wondering what other tricks he has up his sleeve. So instead, I'm going to just block one, save up a regular physical damage, and let's hit him with Flame Arrow for a nice 2. Excellent. So now we're getting closer to back even. Shit. I was afraid of that. All right, we can block one of those, and he hits for 2. Huntsman, this may not end very well, buddy. All right, so let's hit him as hard as we can with this fucking steelhead arrow. Oh, buddy. The fucking ranger. The ranger comes through again. Hot fucking shit. Oh, my God. You know what, Reigns? It's okay, man. It's getting a lot better now. Honestly, the worst part was that my car broke down when I was trying to get home, and I was super duper hungry and looking forward to the dinner that I had, and it kind of pushed back the whole night's plans by about an hour and a half. But you know what? It's getting better now, so who gives a shit? So, here's the thing, Huntsman. Your ranger has a very nice perk attached to him right now that makes it so that one of your loots is of a better level than the others. So you notice here that this Seafarer's Brace, which gives you Retribution, a nice trait to have, Counter, and Mind Strike, is level 2. This Glyph, which will replace your stool, is also level 2. But this Heater Shield is level 3. So that means every time you get a loot drop like this, one of your items will be higher than the other. Now remember, we're about to open a level 2 chest. So you're about to get some more drops here in just a second. So you can get the Heater Shield here. You can get the Seafarer's Brace, which actually wouldn't replace anything, and then we could see what's inside of the chest. Or you can get the Glyph, or you can just take some gold. That is always a choice. You can always just take some gold, and it'll give us a gold card into our next hand, which we can then play on the field and pick up as we go along. You know, Kisty, if I do get you killed, it's not my fault. Well, it will be my fault, but it won't be on purpose, I assure you. So, Huntsman, the choices are yours and yours alone. Good luck. Ooh, excuse me. Well, Huntsman, all right. Shield it is. Are you sure? Are you sure you want to do that? I think I'm going to let you take another shot. Because the Seafarer's Brace doesn't actually cost anything. Okay. Good call, Huntsman. Good call. And now we have another choice here. The Seafarer's Brace, which is exactly the same. So you can sell it for 2 gold. You have the Scimitar, which gives you slice and dice. And then the Wolf Pelt, which will replace, well, the thing that you just got and give you all of those. So I'm going to guess the Scimitar. Because it's the only thing that won't actually replace anything. And also remember, level 3 monster and level 3 chest. So we're going to get some more stuff here in just a minute. Maybe there will be a nice helmet over there, something to replace your stool with something that's a little bit better. We shall see. Huntsman wants the swords. You got it, baby. You got it, baby. The ogre's going to wake up in 7 turns. But it's okay because we're going to have done way more damage than he's going to be able to deal with. Shit. Monster gains conceal for the next fight. That's not good. Alright, so we're gonna move to, and we'll pick up the gold there. Love it. We have 6 turns remaining. I'm gonna go ahead and build this, just so that way it is built and ready. And I almost think I want to take on another level 2 creature. Just to kind of get some more experience up underneath your belt, Huntsman. I mean, we're gonna have to stop in this square anyway, so it might as well be for a purpose. Alright, so the Phylogist Tonic still gives us an additional +1. Mind Blast comes in, and let's counter that with a Steelhead Arrow. And because we took 3 damage there, we deal 1 magic damage thanks to that Retribution tactic. So, as it turns out, that might have been one of the better ways to go. We can go ahead and block one of those damages with our new Bash ability. And I'm thinking that we will Camouflage, which will block one of those and store up a physical. Ha 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 ha! Let's give him an arrow slice for 3 fucking damage. Oh, that's awesome. And then we'll hit him again with another wooden arrow for a straight 1 quickness, which you know what? Does exactly the fucking job we need. And we have another choice here, Huntsman. Awesome. We have the Mail Coif, which will give you that 2 health plus 2 stupidity. We have the Bone Helmet, which will give you Focus and Arcane Barrage, both of which are pretty nice. You do have some magic damage there. Healing and drawing a card would be pretty good. And also that magic damage unblockable. Holy shit, that magic damage unblockable, okay? And then the Anchor, which will replace your Cutlass, but give you Slam and Smash. Not too bad. All right, Huntsman, Helmet of Bone it is. You got it, sir. Look at it, it just sits nice and squarely right on top of your head like a little fez. Okay, so we're gonna go into the Mega Chest and fight the Gargoyle, who is brittle. Taking 4 or more damage in 1 turn causes 2 extra? Holy hot monkey shit. That's kind of nice. I wish I could replace that, whatever, doesn't matter. But we are blind. So that means that we're not going to be able to see the cards that are coming before they come at us. That puts us at a big disadvantage here. Which means that we're probably just going to have to hit him hard and fast. Oh my god. And so we deal 4, which means he takes 2 more. Ha 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 ha! Suddenly this battle turns vicious. We'll block one of his, deal 1 of our own. Love it. This is good. This is good. Bye, Jizbin. We'll see you later on, man. Thank you so, so much for dropping by. Let's see. What else? Nope. Nothing. Shit. Repel did not pay off at all. Okay, let's try camouflage. It's gonna block 1. That's good. This is good. This is good. This is really, really good here. Because we get 4 fucking damage in there before that gargoyle can hit us. And Huntsman wins again! Fuck yeah! Dude! Huntsman, you are just pulling it out of your ass today, man. What the hell? I am so pleased with your performance. The Horned Helm comes along, which will replace Focus and Arcane Barrage with Fury and Eviscerate, both of which are pretty good. The Winged Staff will give you Holy Seal, Smite, and Cerebrate, which heals for 3 and draws 2 cards. And then the Red Mail, which makes you lose Retribution in Arcane Barrage, but you'll gain +1 to health. So I'll leave that choice up to you. Personally, it's a toss-up between the Horned Helm and the Winged Staff. I don't know. That's a tough one. Yeah, I was going to suggest that. I notice us getting closer to low health more often than we should. And so we have another choice here. There's that same Red Mail. And then we have a spear, which is shift and interrupt, both of which are quick, which means that both of which will be now plus two, or will be now two physical damage instead of one. So there's that. And then interrupt, which also does blocks two magic damage. And then we have the bone armor, which is just a straight up plus one. But instead of losing Cerebrate, you lose counter instead. Now, you can also just take the gold. So there's that too. Wow, that sounds really painful, Reigns. Lemonade in your sinuses? Ouch. I am sorry to hear that. I mean, here's the thing. We still have some ground to cover between us and the ogre. So there's lots more opportunity for more gold. So if you want to, we can just take the gold here, lay it out before us, and not really have to worry about losing anything right now. Remember, you'll lose retribution. I haven't seen the kitten for a while, so I don't know where exactly she got to. I'm hoping that she doesn't make any trouble for me. I don't know. I mean, this is legitimately a tough choice. Like, I'm just saying, trust me. My instinct says just take you at the bone armor. But we're so close to actually beating this mission. I don't know. Let's make sure that all of our choices are made with the utmost care. You know? That's all. That's all I'm saying. So right now, he's sleepy and predictable. Just got out of bed, minus three hearts, and predictable. So we've got four turns to make it there before that goes away. All right. So we make it two moves here. Ogre wakes up in three turns. He's got 10 hearts. We've got 9, but we have a buttload of healing. I am not worried about putting any more enemies in our way, dude. Not at all. We're gonna clear this out. We're level 4. He's level who gives a fuck. Let's end turn and end this ogre. All right, Huntsman. You and me, let's do this shit. The Phlogus Tonic gives us plus one heart, so now it's all even here, okay? Shit, he starts out with a pummel, and he's got recharge next. So let's... shit waffles. Let's go ahead and do a Mind Strike for now, which thankfully will deal 2 magic there. He's gonna go ahead and block a little bit. Ooh... this is nice. All right, so we're going to use the focus to draw another card, heal back a heart. And guess what, motherfucker? You think you're going to hurt me? Not today. My arcane barrage is going to deal 5 magic damage. 5. Count them. Motherfucking 5. And he's got stupidity on his hands, too. So now we're going to hit him with a steelhead arrow right square in his face for 2 quick damage. He's got a beat coming up. That's not good. But guess what? We're gonna celebrate good health. Come on! Da-na-na-na as we kick some ass. Woo-woo! And, let's see. The ogre's got 2 stupidity, which means we're gonna hit him square on the face with a flame arrow. And his health melts away. So that ogre is fucking done, son!
If you understand, this used to be a piece of...
that ogre's done! Huntsman, you win!
And I dread to know now what you've planned.
And so, the scar is now in its final stage. Scrounger, 1 loot choice is of a higher level than normal. Cannot take coins instead of loot. Interesting. Okay. But we also got 258 gold from that quest. Or excuse me, got 358 gold. And I think that's enough to buy another thing, is it not? It might be really close. Oh, it's enough to buy another thing! Yes! Yes, motherfucker! So let's see what we're gonna buy. That plus one is really nice. I think we're good on that for now. I think we need to buy some more items. Like, other than saving up for these new and final tiers of people, I think that our other option is just to get more rare items right now. Bark Vest, Cursed Bow, Mind Staff, Spike Shield. Oh, another thing that has spiky. That's pretty good. God, spikes is just so good, you guys. Fish scale cowl, the eye patch, the padded vest, the soul of scrolls. Wow, scroll of souls. Fez, and dead lizard charm. Okay. I think we should go with build, with the fine chisel for now, which will give us some more of these items back in our dungeon. You know, Huntsman, it's funny. We actually have the capability to get a new hero, and I think we're going to do that next. Because you just had to open your big fat mouth, and what will we do for a drunken sailor? We die for him, son. Who should we have up first? I'm thinking it might be time for the Weasel the Apprentice to go in and have his luck. Should we get the Crone's Discipline or the Flogger's Tonic? The Flogger's Tonic really helped us. I think we should go ahead and go with the Tonic. Ha! Weasel's like, anybody but me. Literally anybody but me. Anybody but me. All right. You know what? No, I think that's totally fair. I told Tiamos he could sit out around so that he kind of learn the ropes. Let's go ahead and get him on in here. Tiamos, you're up, my friend. It's time to make some hero fricassee. So at the end of this, there is a key. A key that opens up, well, a jail cell, and behind which is our new class. So, we'll get him in just a second. Alright, so we're going to start out here. Mime, you have 6 plus 1 hearts, so that's going to make it pretty easy to kind of start to level up to begin with. We found out earlier that these oarsmen, even though they may be only 5 hearts, are way, way, way giant assholes. So, we're going to go up here. Right. And we're not going to connect these yet, because that means she's going to be able to start chasing us. Instead, we're going to go ahead and kill this little monkey here as we try and level up before Joe attacks in 10 turns. Oh, Huntsman, you're hilarious. And let's see here. So he's going to start out with a charge. And I think we'll go and block one of those damages with imaginary box. That'll store up a magic token here in just a second. He's going to try and block some physical damage. So I think this is the perfect time to hit him with imaginary cannon, which now does 3 damage. Ah, shit. Okay, well, you know what? He's going to try and plunder and get a heart back. I'm going to deal a damage and make him discard a card. So, even? Even Steven. I call that one. He's going to hit us with a bite, and that's great because we're going to hit him with another magic damage and make him discard yet another card. Fuck you and your headbutt. And yeah, I think we're going to finish this guy off with a nice imaginary cannon. See, that's exactly what I'm talking about, TMOs. This character class, this mime character class, is focused all on card manipulation. Like, we were able to take away his more powerful attacks there. The ones that did 2 damage and would have hurt him one, sure, but would have still dealt 2 damage to us. So, it really kind of behooves of you as a mime player to really kind of think about the way you're going to be able to fuck with people. Especially with discarding cards, cloning cards, that sort of thing. So, we start out here with the eyeball charm, which gives you plus 1 health and fire 1, a nice 2 magic fire blast attack. The Demon Claw, which gives you Slice and Dice, but doesn't make Julianne fries. but the arcane wand has rekindle and mind strike, my friend. So what shall it be? What shall it be? The eyeball charm, which will give you a little bit of extra health and some magic damage, which you already have a decent amount of magic damage. And you do have cards that actually manipulate the amount of magic damage that you do. But you don't have a lot of physical damage, which is where this demon claw could come in handy. If you have something that, like, specifically blocks a lot of magic damage, you could be screwed. And then there's this arcane wand, which has a little bit of healing and a little bit of card mitigation, but not a whole lot. So is it a great item? No. Is it a decent item? Maybe. The choices are yours, and yours alone. Good luck. TMOs. TMOs. Waiting on you, buddy. Well, arcane wand it is. You got it, buddy. All right. So Joe is going to attack us in 9 turns, and we need to get way stronger before then. I don't wanna, but we're gonna go ahead and put another one-headed monkey in our way, see if we can't get another good item here before we take on the Buccaneer. We're gonna end our turn. Make it so that the Buccaneer can't chase us. Not today, sucker. And the one-headed monkey is going to try and plunder from us. But that's great, because we're going to hit him with a stage presence. Fuck that extra heart that you just got. And also fuck your headbutt. Now he's going to come at us with a yoink. But guess what? Doesn't really matter. Sweet. We cloned his charge card. That's actually really great because it doesn't block itself. We just each did dealt 2 damage to each other. And so I'm going to actually use Rekindle now to deal 1 magic damage and heal the one that he just did to us, which is great. Let's go ahead and use anger, or excuse me, imaginary box to block that. And he's, I don't remember when he stole my imaginary cannon. Oh well, not important. Stage presence time. Blap, 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 goes the sound of my gat. As Tiamos wins another round. Good job, sir, good job. And so you have another choice to make. Another set of items to choose from. We have the C charts here, which will give you wise, which gives you +1 starting hand size in battle, and restore. Something that could be very, very good for you to follow down, because you have all of those things that deal magic damage, deal more magic damage. This one deals magic damage and heals 2 hearts if it's successful. And then you have the Demon Claw, which has the slice and dice, but it'll replace your arcane wand, so you'll lose Rekindle and Mind Strike. And then we have the Bandana, which will give you Shift, a quick physical damage dealing 1 card drawing attack. God, excuse me. And Repel, which blocks 3 physical damage. So those are all some pretty good choices. Having Wise is pretty nice, because having multiple cards in, or more cards in your hand is pretty good. Noble said he wants the shards. Noble said he wants the shards. Oh, that's funny as shit. Oh, that's funny as shit. And so, so your other choices are the Demon Claw and the Bandana. Please, you do not, don't take the shards. You really don't want to take the shards. I have a feeling that would be a bad card choice. Huh. Yeah, I think, Noble, I think you should change your name. Bandana, na 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 na. You got it, sir. The bandana is yours. And honestly, here's the thing. We're going to be dealing with a lot of physical damage coming our way here shortly. You might have just made the best choice. Or at least the best choice you could. So we'll put a massive gem here. And I guess we could do a cabin boy. Here's the thing. This girl has the crewmate bonus, which means that if any other pirate person dies, she gets plus one health. So that's not good. Okay, so we're going to go ahead and use imaginary box here. Box him right on in. Block that one physical damage and give us one additional magic damage. Let's go ahead and use repel here to block his headbutt so he deals one to himself. And now he has stupidity. Perfect. Incoming magic damage deals plus one. We can discard his headbutt, and all he has left is anger. And unfortunately, his anger is going to be nice and impotent because we're going to heal back the damage that he does, deal plus one damage thanks to his mundane, and he's fucking dead. You see how easy that was? Do you see how easy that was? That's the thing about the mime class, Tiamos. When you have all of these abilities that allow you to manipulate the opponent's cards, allow you to manipulate your own health values and your own card numbers, like, there are some of these battles that we've done against some of these characters that have been so insanely difficult, and yet now because we have good card choices, it's a breeze. It's an absolute fucking breeze. So, Tiamos, your choices now are a corset, which will give you restore and counter. Two pretty damn good abilities with no downsides. You won't be replacing anything. You have the skull cap, which will replace your shift with counter. And then the arcane glyph, which will give you holy seal, which heals per damage blocked. It blocks one damage, and then you heal per that damage that you blocked. And then focus, which gives you one magic damage at the next magic damage opportunity, one health, and one card. So both are pretty good. Personally, I would lean towards corset, but that's just me. So, I will leave the choice up to you, my friend Tiamos. You are getting awful, awful close to Joe. We have 7 turns left and 1 enemy standing in between us. Ah! Oh, Reigns, you're funny. Oh, that's really cool, Noble. All right. Corset it is, my friend. You'll look very, very sexy in it if I say so myself. And we picked up that massive gem for 5 fucking gold. You damn right, son. And so I reckon that we can put this mysterious fountain here. Come on, please be something good. God fucking Jesus, shit, content, damn it, Christ. I guess that means we don't have to go there. And we'll go ahead and end turn. Which she can't get to us. You know, I was absolutely wondering why she wasn't coming to attack us. And now I know. For some reason, I thought the rooms connected here, but they totally don't. That's kind of nice. Huh. All right, so he's going to start off with his stupidity, which is great for us. So we're going to start off with some stage presence here, deal 2 magic damage, and discard your fucking headbutt. Get your head out of your butt and get it out of here. We're going to deal 2 more magic damage with our rekindle and heal back the one that he just did. I'm thinking that it's time to hit up the repel here, block all that fucking damage. And he's got a headbutt coming our way. We can block one of those. Ha 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 ha. And fuck you, my friend. I will discard a card. Who gives a shit? The battle's over. Tiamos wins again. And so we have the tattered mail, which will give you plus 1 to health, but you'll lose that restore ability. And then the Scimitar, which has Slice and Dice, which you'll lose Restore and Mind Strike. And then the Cultist's Hood, which you'll lose Counter and Shift. Now, if none of those sound appealing to you, you can just take some gold, which, as I said before, will give us a gold card into our next hand, and we could just lay that out there to pick up, probably in that the Lady Buccaneers room. We'll see. But I will leave that choice up to you, my friend. Tattered Mail, the Scimitar, or the Cultist's Hood. I will admit, that Smite and Fire Blast would be pretty good for your character. But, you know, you lose a little bit of physical damage. You don't lose any physical blocking. Well, okay, counter, but I mean, you know, you still have Repel. And you get Holy Seal. So I mean, you're not losing any blocking, really. You're just gaining a different kind of blocking. Okay. You got it. Cultist Hood it is. Oh, look at him. He looks like a little Russian babushka. And so Joe attacks in 5 turns remaining. But before we take him on, I want to kill one more cabin fucking boy and get rid of this blindness that we have on us. And then that Lady Buccaneer is going to get on our asses, and we'll get one more chance at some good items here. He's got Concealed. We know what he has, so he's not really going to be able to screw us out of anything, because I have way more damage available at my disposal than he has blocking capability for me. Especially considering that his own headbutts deal him damage. I mean, basically that was just a non-starter for him. And so now we have the Daisy Chain, which will give you +1 health and growth 1, which is a refresh, which when we use that ability, no matter how many hearts we have, 1 or 12, it'll restore it to 6 first. That quick means it goes first, and we restore right back to 6 hearts. So that can be very useful if we're sitting on 1 and an enemy's about to attack us for a lot, and all we need to last is one more turn. That refresh can be the difference between life and death, literally. The crossbow, which gives you shift and interrupt, both are pretty decent. And then the club, which gives you bash in exchange for mind strike.
You know, they can go out of the way.
And then on top of that, the gold card. So, yeah, there you go. Listen, Weasel, I don't know why he's having sex with a cabin. Who am I to judge? I am not Judgy McJudgerton up in here, okay? You don't see me going around judging people for the kinds of cocks they put in their mouth. I don't care. That's just what they do. And so what would you like to do, TMOs? You're welcome to take one of these items, which, to go back through, we have the Daisy Chain, we have the Crossbow, and we have the Club. And then, of course, you can just take some gold. Yeah? Now, here's the thing. Normally speaking, I would just go on your first choice, because that's the way we play around here. You live by the choice, you die by the choice. But I'm actually going to suggest that you don't make that move and instead take the gold, because that refresh is nice. Yes, don't get me wrong, that refresh is nice. But you have so many good magic damage augmenting abilities. That Smite and that Fire Blast kind of are really great for you. So I would suggest, at least for this choice, just taking the gold. Now, we don't have an offhand item yet, so we're still not as good as we can be. Hopefully within the next fight, we will get some sort of offhand item. But for now, for this turn at least, I would suggest taking the gold. Okay. And so here she comes for us. The Ladybuck. And we're gonna have to put her down too. Alright, the head blow's coming. She's got aggressive and crewmate. The good news is she didn't see anybody die, so we're good to go there. But she has fury. So all physical attacks deal plus one once she's at half health. This could be interesting. Shit. Okay, so we're gonna start off here with restore. Hopefully we'll lose rekindle. That's fine. That's totally fine. She's gonna hit us with thrash. And I'm gonna hit stage presence. And we will make her discard this lunge. So she'll use strike next, which is great because now we get to have the health advantage here. But it's bad because now she's at half health. So now she's gonna start hitting super duper hard. But the good news is she's now down to one heart. Fuck. Fuck. Are you kidding me right now with this shit? That is a 5 damage ability that she's about to lay in front of us. What the fuck? Four, five. We both died. We both died.
Once again, they tried in vain.
The good news is, Tiamos, you took her out with you, my friend. You didn't die alone, okay? You slayed each other like the vicious pirates that you were, and you'll end up buried together. Unfortunately, yeah, like Kisty just pointed out, ties go to the computer. The house always wins. And so another mime has been laid into the invisible box in the ground. I'm sorry, Tiamos. Your name will go in the pantheon of those who have fallen before you. You didn't get out much. You tried. You earned 39 gold. And you killed 5 things. You killed 5 things. Do you know how many people that we have that didn't kill 5 things? Look at this! Okay, Huntsman's a bad example. Huntsman kills things all the time. Okay, Dan's a bad example. Dan kills things all the time. Noble killed 5 things one time. Harwood only killed 3. I mean, like, you know. You did a hell of a lot better than a lot of other people around here. There are a lot of people that didn't make it through one goddamn round. Due to, you know, the failure of certain people around the studio. Shut up, finger. And, so, I feel like that was a pretty good damn job. Especially for your first run. Okay. You know what? I think we should try this run one more time before we get out of here. I'm thinking that's a good idea. Let us go ahead and take in somebody with a good bit of strength here. Where is our bruiser? Unfortunately, Jiz been left out. Weasel wants to go. All right, Weasel, you got it, my friend. Weasel, you want to go? You got it. And we're going to stick with our Phylogis Tonic. That's working out pretty well for us most of the time. And now we just need to run! Because the cave collapses in 9 turns and we have to get the fuck down here. Okay, let's go ahead and start out. There is a fountain of blindness over there. That's not good. Let's go ahead and lay out some dungeon tile here. That is good. And a playground. Just for fun and also profit. Weasel's gonna move forward 1 square. And let's see what we've got here. Ooh. I will put the gold pouch there. And I will put the gold pouch there. And I'm thinking that I might actually put some pixies here, too. Just to kind of give us something else to fight. 2 level 1 items is a hell of a lot better than 1. And by the time we reach that chest, we'll have 3 items at our disposal. Are you kidding me? That's fucking great. Bite comes along. Let's go ahead and counter with an unblockable of our own. Fuck you, plague rat. Fuck you and the horse you rode in on. He's going to hit us again with another fucking bite. But it's okay. Let's go ahead and draw 2 cards with imposition. Intuition, imposition. This whole fight is an imposition. And in he comes with some more goddamn physical damage. Oh boy. Oh boy. Oh boy. Oh boy. I think I see where this is going. Weasel. Unfortunately, today was Weasel Stomping Day. I'm sorry, my friend, you did not make it far. Your defeat was heard near. I'm sorry, my friend. I didn't do anything! I didn't even get the chance to do anything! That wasn't my fault! You know what, Weasel? Here's the thing. You had a battle scar that meant that you started with -1 health as the apprentice. And there wasn't much that I could do about that. I'm sorry. So who do we want to send in next? Oh, good gravy. I need somebody with some physical blocking ability. You know what? I want that bruiser to go in, but let's get somebody in that bruiser spot who's here. I believe the jizz bin kind of came in and out, so let's go ahead and put somebody in. Who do we have available? Tiamos, Dan, double Dans, Huntsman, Awer, and Kisty. You know what? I lied. I'm going to make Tiamos our bruiser. He deserves another shot here. And then I'm going to change this mime over to Noble. As we've seen, the mime is far from a worthless class. I believe you'll be able to find some good benefits there. Oh yeah, is that right? Jason, are you here? If you're here, Jason, I'll be glad to plug you into the game if you want to play. But I think that first, let's go ahead and bring in Tiamos with the bruiser. We got to be able to block some physical damage and run the hell away here. So let's... Okay, cool. All right, Jason, you got it. You will be our next chat venturer as we go through here. It looks like we have ourselves a nice, awesome leggy spider, which is way easier to deal with that than that plague rat. So we might actually be able to work that out here. And then I want to use. This corridor. But I don't think I want to use any of these enemies. I think I'm going to hold off on that. All right, so he's going to hit us with a drain. And nice try, chum. Fuck you. You don't heal a heart. In fact, you take a damage. Let's go ahead and block both of these physical. And in comes an unblockable attack. That's fine. We'll go ahead and hit it with two of our own. And this becomes still an even fight. He's got spook. I've got an unblockable attack. And suddenly, we're in the lead. Let's go ahead and block one, deal two, and that leggy spider has been squashed. Awesomely enough. Good job, Tiamos. And so now you have your first choice underneath this bruiser character. We have the leather-bound tome, which will give you Mind Strike and Fire Blast. We have the Arcane Wand, which will give you Rekindle and Mind Strike. And then the Pigeon's Nest, which will give you Growth, also known as Rekindle. Hi, Radius. Welcome. Glad you could join us. So what shall you choose, my friend? Mind Strike, Fire Blast, Rekindle, Mind Strike. So basically, your choice is whether you want Fire Blast or Rekindle. Because Pigeon's Nest also has Rekindle, so, you know, the choice is basically between the Arcane Wand and the Tome. I trust in your judgment, Teemos. Well, the good news is you're about to get another item here in just a second. Let's see what we have to kill to get it. It'll be another plague rat. The good news is you're a lot better equipped to deal with that plague rat, and because it was in a dead end, it got minus one heart. So that's awesome news. We can go ahead and hit that son of a bitch. Oh, really? All of this unblockable damage that he has. Excellent. So we can block that spider bite, and there's the spike damage. And guess what, punk? Oi! Slap! That plague rat is down. And we have another choice of loot. We have the brass knuckles, which will be a nice little bash and slam attack. We have the eyeball charm, which will replace your book but give you plus one health. And then we have the fork, which gives you slice. A nice little two physical damage dealing attack. And remember, we are on a space that has a chest, which is level two, so you'll get another choice of item here in just a second. Be wary of that. What shall you pick, my friend? I believe in the power of your choice. I believe in all things that you are able to do. I believe in a thing called love. Just so it doesn't hurt our heart. I believe in a thing called love! Woo-hoo-hoo-hoo. Guitar. Teemos wants the brass knuckles. You got it, my friend. Bash and slam. And what's inside the chest? We have the Seafarer's Brace yet again, which gives you Retribution, Repel, and Focus. All of which are great things on the Bruiser. And then we have the Glyph, which will replace your book, giving you Holy Seal instead of Fire Blast. And then we have the Parrot on your shoulder, which will replace the book with Rekindle and Smash. I don't know. Kind of seems like the Seafarer's Brace is the best way to go, right? Right? You know, Reigns, here's the thing. If I want to eat a pizza in one sitting, I'll get a thin crust pizza because I can eat a whole, like, medium-sized thin crust pizza by myself and still stay this skinny. If I want a pizza that I have to split up over two servings, then I'll get a regular-style pizza, like a regular pan or a regular-style pizza. Because then I can only eat, like, half of it because that's a shit ton more bread. And, you know, can only eat half the damn thing because I'm a big fat fatty who loves his fat fat fattiness. Air elemental. So it's a bulwark, so it wanders every turn and it's bulwark. If you take exactly one damage on a turn, prevent it. Okay, I think I want to take out actually really don't want to take out any of them. I want to build more tiles around these guys. So that way they're surrounded and have this debuff. That would be great. Unfortunately, I can't. And it only needs... He only needs two more tiles before he drops a heart. Which will make him a lot easier. And I am going to drop some gold in the square too. I think I'm just gonna end turn. We're gonna stop here at this massive gym, and so we might get the chance to get another item. But here's the thing, 1, 2, 3, 4 turns. That's 4 turns right there. I almost don't need any more distractions. There's the owlbear. We're gonna have to take on an owlbear. Okay, so this is basically it now. This is our final run to the finish. We have to go through 1, 2, 3 enemies, collecting a bunch of items along the way. And then here's our last turn. All right, Teemos. You and me, buddy. We're right here, okay? You and me, we're right here. Mano y mano. Against the game. Let's end turn. All right, you fucking massive plant. I've got a fire tome with your fucking name on it. Man-eating plant? Prepare to be eaten by man! Oh, that venomous bite. Okay, there we go. Nice and even. Spider bite comes along. We're going to be able to block that damage, which is great. In comes the spike damage. He's got a stupidity. Fucking awesome. We're gonna hit him hard with a slam. Nice 2 unblockable damage. Here comes the acid spit. That's gonna deal full 3, and I am not happy about that shit. But at least we can hit him for 1. Aha! Because we have retribution, it hit for 2 instead. Awesome. And he's got a straight. Oh, fucking thank you for a stupidity card! Fucking plants are so stupid! And it makes me so happy because we win another battle, folks. And Tiamos, you get another piece of items. So we have the stiletto, which will replace your brass knuckles and give you shift and slice. And then we have tattered mail, which will replace your scale mail, giving you +1 health, but you'll lose retribution and focus, which we don't want. And then we have the shimmering cloak, which will give you flame lash, but you'll lose those things too. So I'm actually going to go with the gold here. We'll put the gold inside of that, last space with the, bear owl, whatever the fuck they call it in this game. And that'll be our loot there. Alright. So we'll put you right here. Let's go ahead and see if we can't fill out. Oh, fuck. Come on. Come on. Give me something somewhere. Yes! 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 Fuck you, lizard man. You are now at -1 heart. So that's 7 instead of 8. We're at 9 instead of 8. So suddenly, this becomes a much more one-sided fight in our favor. Fuck your neurotoxin. We're not discarding shit. In fact, you're taking a damage. Fuck your pummel, because we're gonna deal 3 damage right back to you. Thanks to retribution, we're gonna block your claw damage, which deals 1 more spike damage to you and punches you in the face. Get the fuck out of here. Oh, that restores 2 hearts. That's not good. Okay, we're gonna focus, restore a heart of our own. Okay, we're good. We're good. We're good. We're good. Totally good here. God, if only I could block 2. I wish I could block 2 and deal some back. Oh well, it's fine. He hits us for 2. We hit him for 2 unblockables, so he's back down to 1. And there's that restore again. Son of a bitch. I wish I had some sort of quick damage, but I don't. Is he really going to regenerate his way out of this fight? No, he's not, because we're going to block his 1 damage, hit him with the spikes, and then the final bash in the face. Excellent. Victory is ours. And so that means we have another choice on our hands here, Tiamos. We have the spiky hat, which gives you counter, slice, and motherfucking dice. Are you kidding me? That's awesome. And then we have the cooking pot, which gives you smash and flame blash, both of which are not bad either. That is a quick 2 magic damage attack. And also a 3 physical damage dealing, 1 physical damage blocking attack. Not too shabby. And then we have the scimitar here, which gives you slice and dice, but will replace your brass knuckles. The cooking pot and the spiky hat don't actually replace anything, so bear that in mind. Slice and dice, or smash and flame lash, sir. I will leave that choice up to you. That's basically 3 medium attacks, or 2 very powerful ones. Because, 2 magic damage is pretty decent by itself, but 2 magic damage quick, suddenly that's a superpower. Especially considering that we have that retribution trait, which means that if we take more than 3 physical damage, we actually deal an extra magic. The choices are yours, and yours alone! Alright, the cooking pot it is. And so with the cave collapsing in 3 turns, time to take on this owlbear, folks. The bad part is this owlbear 100% has fury. So once we get it down to half damage, we're going to have to hit it hard and hit it fast. And that's going to be, what, 4 hearts? Okay. All right. I got to close my door real quick. Stand by. My roommate just went to bed, and so to be considerate to him, I went ahead and closed the door so that way when I start yelling and screaming, it'll be a little bit less loud inside of his ear holes. So I guess here we go. Here we go, Tiamos. This is it, baby. This is for all the money. He's going to start off with a nice, hard, unblockable lunge. But that's fine. We're going to hit him in the face with a fucking fire blast. And owlbears are notorious for hating fire. We'll block his one physical, deal a spike, and one back. So now Fury is activated. He's going to try and hit us with Neurotoxin. Good news is, spikes comes in. We won't discard a card this time, sucker. Oh, shit. Shitty shit shit. That's 4 damage coming our way. But the good news is we can deal one back. Oh, motherfucker. Oh, that retribution. Oh, my God, that retribution, you guys. Tiamos, you did it. Tiamos, you fucking did it. Like, we tried this thing like 7 times last week. And we never did it. We couldn't fucking beat this thing. But you did it. You fucking did it. Yay! And so now take your last loot choice, my friend, but it really won't matter, whatever. You have the Cursed Bow, which gives you DK and ranged, but also shift and interrupt. And then the Cavalier's Hat, which gives you shift, interrupt, and slice. And the Masquerade Mask, which gives you Holy Seal, Smite, and Arcane Barrage. Now, that being said, you can't just take the gold, and we should be able to put a gold into that last little hole. Nope. You know what, Tiamos? I like the way you think, my friend. I like the way you think. And so that's it, folks. Fuck that. Wait, what are you doing? What are you doing? Why are you not going to the exit? I don't
have control over you, dude. I don't have control over you. You go where you want. Like, that's not me. All I can do is set out the plan, okay? You end up walking where you want to walk. Beat, we're going to block that shit. In comes the spike damage. Fuck you. Double fuck you. Triple fuck you. A quadruple fuck you. And now for the final fucking blow. A nice little slice to the face. So the good news is, Tiamos, you and your wandering face hole didn't get us into any trouble this time. And we're going to actually be able to escape just fine. You were going to head back over towards that fountain. But I went ahead and picked the gold so that way I can put the gold down in the fucking final square and get your scrawny ass in it. Okay? I'm the dungeoneering master around here. You're going to listen to me, okay? But thank you. Congratulations! Victory was yours.
What you've planned.
You got us 356 fucking gold out of that too, dude. Like, that is a haul. I am very, very proud of you. I am very, 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 very proud of you. And you got the hard-headed scar, which means that you have +1 heart naturally and -1 hand size in battle, which is actually really great because now that means we can take both the Rune of the Crone, which gives us +1 hand starting size, and you now have that +1 from the other stone that we have. So, as it turns out, you, sir, are pretty fucking good right about now. Reigns, you'll be our new apprentice when we come back. You know what? I lied. Yeah. I'm gonna make Jason something a little bit better. But, unfortunately, the bad news is we have reached 10 o'clock and I must call it an evening for tonight because I have to go to work early in the morning. which sucks. But we'll be back tomorrow, because we're going to be, hopefully, I will have everything set up to test our painting stream. If I don't have everything set up, guess what? We'll be back here playing more of this, so you'll be able to play right along with us, folks. We'll be back tomorrow, probably at around 7 o'clock. If I have to push it to 7:30 due to setting everything up, I will let you guys know on Twitter. But in the meantime, you've been watching this on twitch.tv/TimLeftwich. My name is Tim Leftwich. Let me know if you enjoyed the show. Thank you so much, guys, for all of your contributions to everything that we do around here. It's what keeps me going on these dark and dark and dreary, dreary days. I really needed this today, guys, and I'm so glad that I got to be here and share with you guys for a while. We will be back either tomorrow with some more Guild of Dungeoneering or next week with more Guild of Dungeoneering. But either way, thank you all so much for watching. And as always, we'll see you next time.